Hello students, today we shall discuss about balancing of chemical equation. Why balancing of chemical equation is necessary? To fulfill the law of conservation of mass, it is necessary. What is law of conservation of mass? That is, the total mass always remains constant. Mass cannot be created nor be destroyed. If any reaction proceeds, then total mass of the reactants will be equal to total mass of the product. That is, there will be no change in their mass. That is, the total number of atoms of an element in reactant part will be equal to total number of atoms of that element in product part. So we have to balance chemical equations. Different methods are given to balance chemical equation. Among them, heat and trial method is in your syllabus. What is heat and trial method? Heat and trial method involves three steps. Number one step is frequency of occurrence of an element. We have to determine frequency of occurrence, that is, the number of times of that element occurs on either side. Number two is we have to balance the element first which has least frequency of occurrence. And number three is, if two elements have same number of frequency of occurrence, then among them metal will get preference. Now we take an example. Say iron reacts with water to form ferric oxide Fe2O3 and hydrogen. So to balance this equation, first we have to find out the elements involved in this reaction, that is iron, hydrogen and oxygen. Then the number of atoms of iron in reactant part is 1, and in product part there are 2 iron. Hydrogen in reactant part there are 2 hydrogen, in product part also there are 2 hydrogen. Oxygen in reactant part there is 1 oxygen, and in product part there is 3 oxygen. So here the frequency of occurrence for hydrogen is both in the reactant and product part same, so hydrogen is cancelled out. There is iron and oxygen. Among iron and oxygen, iron has less frequency of occurrence, so we have to first balance iron. So in step 1, we have to balance iron. There are 2 iron atoms in the product side, so we have to put 2 before iron in reactant side, and then iron atoms will be balanced. And in step 2, then we have to balance the number of oxygen atoms. There are 3 oxygen in the product side, so we have to put 3 oxygen in reactant side, that is, we have to put 3 before water. Then there will be 6 hydrogen atoms, so before hydrogen in product part H2 molecule we have to also put 3. Now we take second example, that is potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7 reacts with HCl to form KCl, chromium trichloride, chlorine and water. The elements involved are similarly potassium, chromium, chlorine, hydrogen, oxygen, and the number of atoms of potassium in reactant part 2, in product part 1, number of atoms of chromium in reactant part 2, in product part 1, number of atoms of chlorine in reactant part 1, product part 2. There are 6 chlorine atoms. For hydrogen in reactant part there is 1 hydrogen, in product part there are 2 hydrogens, and oxygen in reactant part there is 7 oxygen, in product part there is 1 oxygen. So here the frequency of occurrence for potassium, for chromium and for hydrogen, this is same. As among potassium, chromium and hydrogen, if we apply the third rule, that is, if elements have same number of frequency of occurrence, then we have to prefer the metal for balancing first. Here potassium and chromium are metal, where hydrogen is non-metal. So we have to first balance potassium and chromium. So in step 1, we will balance first potassium and chromium. There are two potassium atoms and two chromium atoms. So we have to put 2 before potassium chloride and 2 before chromium trichloride. As here one molecule of dichromate is involved in this reaction, so there are 7 oxygen in one molecule of 7 oxygen atoms in one molecule of dichromate. So we have to put here, to balance the oxygen, 7 before the water molecule. Then there are 7 oxygen atoms at product site, 7 oxygen atoms at reactant site. Step 3. Then we have to balance the number of hydrogen atoms. There are 14 hydrogen atoms in product site. There are 14 hydrogen atoms. So we have to put 14 HCl in reactant site. Then the remaining atom which is unbalanced, that is the chlorine atom. In step 4, we have to balance the chlorine. In reactant side, there are 14 chlorine atoms, and in product side, there are 2 plus 6, that is 10 chlorine atoms. Then we have to put another 8 chlorine atoms, that is we have to put another 6 chlorine atoms in the product side, and this is given by putting 3 before chlorine. Then there are 6 chlorine atoms, here are 4 chlorine atoms, 6 plus 4 10, and plus 6 plus 6 12 plus 2, that is 14 chlorine atoms. Then all the atoms are balanced. So this is the complete chemical equation. Now we take another example, that is the reaction of lead oxide with ammonia to produce lead plus water plus nitrogen. Here the elements similarly involved are lead, nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, and similarly you find out the frequency of occurrence for lead. There is in reactant part 1, product part 1 atom. For nitrogen, reactant part 1 atom, product part 2 atom. For oxygen, reactant part 1 atom, and in product part there is 1 atom. And hydrogen, reactant part 3, and in product part there are 2 hydrogen atoms. So for lead, lead is balanced. And for nitrogen and oxygen, there are frequency of occurrence 1, 2, and oxygen is also balanced here. For nitrogen, the frequency of occurrence is 1, 2. And for hydrogen, the frequency of occurrence is 3, 2. So here we have to, as nitrogen has less frequency of occurrence, so we have to first balance the nitrogen atoms. Here are 2 nitrogen atoms in product side, so we have to put 2 before ammonia in reactant side. Thus nitrogen atoms are balanced. In step 2, we have to balance the oxygen atoms. As there are before oxygen, we have to balance, after nitrogen, we have to balance the number of hydrogen atoms. In reactant part, there are 6 hydrogen atoms. So, in product part, to make 6 hydrogen atoms, we have to put 3 before water molecules. Then the number of hydrogen will be balanced. So, to balance the number of oxygen atoms, there are 3 oxygen. So, we have to put 3 before lead oxide, then there will be 3 lead atoms and reactant side, so we have to put 3 before lead in product side. So this is the complete balanced equation. Number 4 is another example, lead tetroxide. When reacts with HCl, hydrochloric acid forms lead chloride, water and chlorine. Here the elements involved are lead, chlorine, hydrogen and oxygen, and these are their frequency of occurrences, where chlorine and hydrogen has less frequency of occurrence. As here one molecule of lead tetroxide is involved in this reaction, so we have to put, and one molecule contains three lead atoms, so we have to put 3 before lead chloride in the product site. Then, and there are 4 oxygen in one molecule of lead tetroxide, so you have to put 4 before water molecules in product side. Then the number, then in step 2 you have to balance the number of hydrogen atoms. There are 8 hydrogen atoms in product side, so you have to put 8 before hydrochloric acid. And then the number of chlorine atoms, you see there are 8 chlorine atoms, and in product side there are 3 into 6 2 6 plus 2, that is 8 chlorine atoms, that is all atoms are balanced. So this is the balanced chemical equation. Thus we can balance any chemical equation. Here for your homework I am giving 2 chemical equations. One is phosphorus reacts with nitric acid to form nitrogen dioxide, phosphoric acid and water, and the second is sodium chloride reacts with manganese dioxide and sulfuric acid to form sodium bisulfate, manganese sulfate, chlorine and water. You have to balance these 2 equations. This is your homework. Now you will also do all the balancing of equations given in your book in exercise part. This is also your homework. Thank you.